Are you on? Going to be on with? Or
I'll be out, sitting off to the side here. We should be on, maybe. Maybe. There we go. Let's see if I can finagle this. Hey, what's up, everyone? We got Vincent Stanley, JM Gaming, Ryu, Chris Flow, Amanda, Kyle Earlywine, Brantley Cooper, Jacob, Lara. Guys, I'd like you to meet Dan, my father-in-law.
Hi.
Yeah, throw up the hashtag Dan not Dave.
Yep.
Hashtag Dan not Dave. Hey, what's up, Burk Jerk? Mickey. We got two Mickeys in the house. So guys, this is Dan. This is the one that, this is who the channel is named after. You're not going to see me. Here's my hand. I'm sitting right beside Dan. You just can't see me. Hey, what's up, Sir Wine Time? James Reniger, Rodney. Rodney's out there.
Oh,
what's
nice.
Up, Roddy? Addison, Jesus Santos, Kyle Earlywine, Curly,
nice.
Kyle Earlywine, John the Gamer, Vincent Stanley. I already said that. All right, guys.
That's
so
awesome. So you got people here.
We're going to wait a couple minutes
just
to let everyone trickle in. But yeah, so this is Dan, guys. I don't know, Dan, do you want to say anything?
No, it's great to be on here for a change with some things going on. I haven't been able to participate in the channel at all, and Dave's done amazing with the Mario Maker.
I don't know about that, but
really added the subs. Holy cow. I mean, it was only like 300.
And, I know. It's,
yeah, really
it's crazy.
Proud member.
Yep, proud
so.
Member. It's been pretty good. Hey, what's up, Dino Rex? How's it going, man? Guys, this is something new that we're trying. With live stream repairs, if you've done any repairs before, you know, there's always a risk that
that's true.
Something might go wrong. So, you know, with doing it live, you know, there's a chance that, you know, repair might not completely fix, but you know, that's not a bad thing because Dan has done so many repairs, which I'm sure he'll tell you about, but you know, stuff goes wrong and he's going to be able to talk you through it and, you know, give you real life scenarios on what to do if, you know, if you encounter a problem. So pretty cool.
And that is true. I mean, there's been times that I've a normal repair, like for example, an Xbox 360 drive replacement, normally it's a 10-15 minute repair,
mm-hmm.
and it'll turn into 2 to 3 hours for unknown reasons.
I remember those.
We get in, boy, they get you so mad, you know. So
oh,
but you get
that.
To see some of that. We'll try and keep the anger down if it doesn't hold.
We won't try to rage and crash the system. Hey, what's up, Travis? How's it going? All right, can everyone hear? Is the sound okay? Everything good on that end? Before we go ahead and get started. What's up, JM? We'll wait to see, make sure everything's sound-wise okay. Everything's good like that. I appreciate you guys coming out. Something new that we're trying. Or, you know, if there's any repairs that you want to see, I know Travis has a Game Boy repair, and Jacob wants to see how to fix a Super Nintendo battery. So we'll definitely be able to do that.
Yeah, let us know what you want us to repair,
absolutely.
And we'll definitely attempt to do that for you, or at least get you in the right avenue.
Absolutely. And the point of this live stream is that, you know, you guys can ask questions if you want, you know, during the repair, if, you know, and the original plan was, you know, if you have the system, you can do this along at home, you know, if you wanted to, or what's cool is that you can just see what the inside of an original NES looks like, which is pretty cool. Hey, what's up, Shaq? How's it going, man? Welcome to the stream. Hey, what's up, Mike? I am here. I'm just off to the side.
He's helping me out. This is my first live stream ever.
First live stream. So, yeah, we're just gonna double team this. Hey, what's up, Gunner? How's it going? All right, guys. We might as well go ahead and, you know, Dan, if you want to discuss.
Yeah, we can talk about it.
Yeah, absolutely.
But basically, anybody that's ever had a Nintendo anymore, the systems are, you know, 30 years old
now.
Yeah,
1985 was it, right? Yeah.
So, I mean, there's a lot of things that, not a lot of things that can go wrong with them, actually, believe it or not. So, a couple of things. I guess the first thing would be to check is your cartridge.
Yep.
And we'll just go over a quick cleaning. And I'm sure most of you already know this, and I know it's preliminary, but we're going
to
go over
it. It's still good to go over.
Yeah,
because
if you keep your games clean, and once the system has a pin set change, normally they'll last another 30 years
you
for sure.
That's the nice thing about old systems is there's not moving parts or anything in them. So the problems are typically not too bad of a fix. It's when there's lasers and stuff.
Yeah, with the newer systems, more mechanical and things like that.
Yeah, absolutely.
But a little bit of alcohol, 91% or better, in a Q-tip. And we've covered this in one of the early videos.
91% or better alcohol. You can get that at Walmart right. for like a buck or two.
Yeah, that'll last you a lifetime, yeah, yeah, the exactly. average person.
Hey, what's up, Co-Pits? And
then just go on either side of the cartridge and just basically you're scrubbing it.
Yep.
And it seems like you always get dirt off them. It don't yep. matter how well they're clean. They seem like they still, and I don't know if you can see that, but you can see the dirt. And then you go behind with a dry one. Give it a good blow, as always. That's why they came up with all them shirts.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
And, you know, and we still have a flashing system. Now, a lot of times, you know, the Pinset can be dirty, and I think anymore it's as cheap as the Pinsets are to purchase.
Yeah.
It's just as easy. They're fairly easy to change. Just change them out.
Yeah. How much does a Pinset normally go for?
You're looking anywhere from like $6 to $10 free shipping off of eBay.
Okay.
You know, and sometimes they'll even send you the screwdrivers and some of the security bits to open the cartridges sure. and stuff like that. We can cover that
absolutely.
Another time.
Absolutely. So about $10
to fix
it.
You get the flashing system. Everybody's had that.
Yep.
You know, so basically what we're going to do is we're going to do a Pinset change on this system here.
You can buy those right on eBay, right? The Pinsets?
Yeah, the Pinsets come in. They come in a little plastic bag normally. They send them to you. They're brand new. Not a whole lot to them. They're 72 pins, they call them.
Yep.
NES 72 pin set. So you need to purchase that. You only need a Phillips head screwdriver. And I'm going to use a power driver just for time. It saves a lot of time opening the system.
Yeah,
but just
yep,
a regular
Phillips.
Screwdriver that's, you know, at least 4 inches long because some of the crevices are deep to get the Phillips heads out. An eraser, and we'll show you what that's for later if you need it. 91% or better alcohol, and that's basically it.
Yeah, there's not a whole lot to it, which is nice. You know, it's a very nice repair, you know, because a lot of people have these NESs and a lot of them have been in attics for 30
right.
years because they don't work, and this is going to show you how to
yeah, and their
that.
Frustration, you blow until you're blue in the face, stick two cartridges in there to hold them
yeah.
tight. And
there's all sorts of techniques.
Yeah, anybody that's had
Everyone's got a
system.
Secret technique.
Yeah, you know, blow on it, tap twice, flip it over, put it in. You know,
yep,
there's so
yep.
many ways. But the first thing you'd want to do, obviously, is unhook the system.
And who else came in? Hey, what's up, Yapoyo? Welcome, man. Welcome. Do you repair pin set contact on the motherboard? That is one of the
things. You can. I mean, the pin set contacts on the board of the NESs, if they've been corroded, sometimes they can be repaired, yes. But it's a little bit more complicated of a repair. You definitely have to know a little bit more about soldering and things like that. You can run jumpers, but maybe in a later date we can cover
sure,
some of that.
Absolutely. This is,
you know,
the world is our oyster.
Yeah.
There's a lot that we can cover, which is,
right.
this is what's exciting.
Yeah, go ahead.
But no, go ahead. Nope.
And sometimes, you know, like if they have been set in a basement where there was a lot of moisture, you'll see when you open the system up that there's been moisture damage, corrosion, and that I think that's what he's talking about on the board.
Yeah,
is
yeah,
I've
yeah.
seen that over the years where
yep.
you know the contacts on the board have actually eroded away.
Oh yeah, I've
but there are
that.
Techniques for pick, you know, fixing that.
Sure.
So I mean, the first thing we're going to do, we have the Nintendo itself. There's 6 screw holes on the bottom, and what we're going to do is just take them 6 screws out. Basically, that's it for that. Pretty simple.
Hey, what's up, Zach Allen? How's it going, man? Welcome. What's up, American 101 and Javon? How's it going, guys? Welcome. If you're just joining, we are fixing an original NES that came back out in 1985. And a lot of times the problem with the systems is that it won't play your game. So we're going to show you how to fix that. That's what's going on right now.
Then just flip it back over when you take the 6 screws out. I usually flip the lid over and use that for a tray for my screws.
Yep, that's a good idea.
And one thing you'll notice with the NES, all the screws other than 2 are the exact same. The only difference between the 2 screws and these screws is it's actually about half as long, or 1.5 times the length of one of these. And I'll show you where that's at. So when you reassemble, it's very important that those screws go back into the same spot. But this is what you'll see when you take the top off. This here is the shielding, and you got another 6 screws that are holding this shielding on, so we're going to have to remove that.
It's a beautiful thing.
Yeah,
the
guts.
Top off.
And the amazing thing is it was produced for, God, 85 to 92 before they switched the models. I mean, internally,
oh, yeah.
all of them are almost identical. Every
That's
one
nice.
Of them. Every one of them is identical. Like today where you have like the Xbox and then it changes the Slim and they actually change the internals.
Yep.
Where the, like this remain the same. For such a long period of time.
But what's nice about the older one is with the blinking lights, you know, you can tell there's power to
right.
it. Where I actually have a slim model is what they call it, or small, whatever
yeah,
they
the
call
top
it.
Loader.
Top loader, yeah. And, you know, the power, when you turn it on, there's no power light indicator, so you can't tell if there's something wrong. The game's not playing, you can't tell if there's something wrong with your power or what.
Right.
So it's kind of nice.
And I can't believe they cut that out. I mean, it's
I
probably
know.
Like a nickel to put
know,
an LED
exactly.
light in there for as much as they're producing. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this shielding off. There's six screws around it. You can't miss them. They're all pretty highlighted there. You'll see every one of them. So
it's just on the metal part.
Right.
Hey, what's up, Game Master? How's it going, man? So, yeah, the NES, while Dan's taking these out, I mean, the NES is basically what got Nintendo on the map. And, you know, so many great games. If you've not played a Nintendo before, I mean, that's how Zelda got started out. That's how Mario got started out. That's how Metroid got started out. That's how, you know, a lot of great Nintendo franchises got their start on this system. So it is a classic and worth having for sure.
Yeah, and a lot of ones that it saved the video game
yeah,
industry at the time.
For
it
sure.
brought it out from the days of Atari collapsing. And
for sure, absolutely.
You know, it's a classic, even today. I mean, it's amazing how many young people.
Oh, yeah,
playing it.
Yeah.
I
when,
mean, you're.
Yeah, we have a lot of young people watching,
right.
I'm sure, that, you know, didn't even grow up with this system, but, you know, it's a collector's
it
item, and people want to play it on the original console, so.
Right, with the original controllers, not through emulation, you know. We
some people don't mind it, but,
right.
you know, I personally like to hold the controller in my hand. Hey, what's up, Zio Kim and George McDuck? How's it going, guys? Welcome, and Mario Fan 23.
Okay, and then once you release the shield, you have all the screws out, you just grab it and pull it. This side, there's a little catch here. And you'll see, you just pull it back, and the whole shielding comes off. And then you expose the actual system here. You can see part of the motherboard over here. I'm looking at everything kind of backwards for me, so it's my point initially to the... there's
the
carriage, the lock, you know, in the front. So what we're going to do after that is there's actually two screws here next to this, what they call a capacitor that's sticking out. There's two screws there. We're going to take those out as well.
The biggest thing with this system fixing it is that unscrewing.
Yeah,
I mean,
a lot
of your time is going
right.
to be disassembling.
Yeah, that's why a power driver is nice if you do a lot of them. You know, and a magnet tip always helps. That way you're not dropping the screws back in there. So now that we have that, we've actually released the motherboard from the plastic shell. And then we have six more screws. And these will be the last six that actually hold the carriage and where the cartridge goes in. And you can see from back here, this is the pin set that we're going to actually pull off and replace. Sounds more complicated than it is. Very simple.
Yeah.
So we're going to take those six screws out, too.
Someone asked us what our thoughts on the new NES Mini that they're coming out with Nintendo. You excited for that?
I am excited
for that. I'm personally
excited
for it.
I think it's
looking forward to it.
And it shows you that the retro never dies, you know?
Yep, absolutely. Hey, what's up, Mikey, L the Gamer, the Gaming Corn, and Kevin the Lazy. What's up, guys? Welcome, welcome, welcome. What is this kind of magic? Yeah, I like
it
this magic.
All right, and then I had talked to you briefly about longer screws. Well, they're here on the carriage. They're actually, I saved them for last. They look exactly the same from the top. But they're in line with the pin set, and they're longer screws. They actually go farther into the plastic, and it helps hold that in when you're jamming them cartridges in. It keeps the pin set firm.
Yeah.
So that's, and you'll see. I can show you.
Yeah, that's
once
like probably the most important thing is making sure that you get those screws back
right where they belong.
Yeah.
And if you do use a power driver, the biggest thing is to set the torque settings on them that you're not stripping the screws.
Yeah.
You don't have to over tighten anything in here. I mean, everything that it's screwing into is plastic. So you can see, thank you, Dave, my magic hands.
Yeah.
But you can see, I don't know if you can see that, how much longer that screw is. Like, I'll put it down where the bottom is. And it's the only two other than that. And it's easy to find in the set when you have them in there.
Yeah.
Because they're longer than everything
The way
else.
I remember, because I've fixed a couple of these when I used to work at the store, was, you know, there's six. There's two up top,
right.
One right below it, and then one right below it. The big ones go in the middle.
Right.
That's the way I remember.
Perfect. That's easier. Sometimes I'm accused of making things overcomplicated, and I probably very well do.
That's all right.
So now that you have all this, everything's loose in here, I can actually touch and pull it. What I usually do is I grab the carriage right here by this, and you can pick up the whole board. so you can see the hole underneath of it and everything there.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
So, what all I do is I actually take the board and I pull this carriage right here.
Actually, let me, I'm going to fix this, guys. I'm going to point the camera. I should have done this a little bit earlier. I'm going to point the camera. Point
yeah.
So, say goodbye to Dan's lovely face. We're going to look at the system a little bit. There we go.
So, and I just pull this and pull it forward. Now, sometimes it's a little tight.
I can hold it.
There we go.
See, and then you pull that out. Now, this is the carriage here that holds the cartridge, and you push it down, it locks it. Now, sometimes this carriage can actually go bad and it doesn't want to lock it down. Very simple repair. You can buy these off of eBay for like $7 or $8 as well. So you can just actually replace this carriage. So now we're going to the culprit. The problem with this system all the time is this pin set here, right here. Very simple. You just grab the board, just grab the back of the pin set, and just pull it cockeyed. Pull it from one corner, and there you go.
There
pin set's completely off. And
you remove the tumor.
Yep, remove the bad one. You know, it could be loose, could be corrosion. Looks like it might have a little corrosion on it. So it doesn't make contact with the cartridges, all the pins in the cartridges. And then what you want to observe, and the one gentleman mentioned earlier about this being corroded,
sometimes
these get corroded, and you will definitely have to repair these because a new pin set wouldn't fix that if it can't make contact with that. Sometimes corrosion can be cleaned off if it's just mild, and there's a couple of different ways to do that. You can use a pencil eraser, and what you do is just scrub it, you know, just work on it like you're erasing somebody put pencil on a paper. You want to just pretty clean. You can do, and you do need to do both sides, you know, like that. If they're, you know, you check them. If they're clean, what I just say is take a Q-tip and alcohol, just like you cleaned your cartridges. You know, a little bit of alcohol, nothing too crazy.
Someone said you can call the warranty on the bottom of the console. Yeah. Call Nintendo, they'll fix it for you.
But you take your alcohol and just clean the board just like that. Just clean it just like you did a cartridge. And that's basically what you're doing. You can see like the dirt that comes off of those even over time.
Oh, yeah, there's a lot on there. Hey, what's up, Justin? How's it going, man? Welcome, my friend.
And then just do both sides.
And Lugia, my man, how's it going, dude? And Alex, what's up, guys? Hey, what's up, DJ? Titan Wolf, how's it going, dude?
And then you just make sure they're nice and clean. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take our new pin set. And we'll set that over. That way you don't mix it up. If you open the bag prior to, and I've done this in the past, I've put the old one back in. So I always wait till the very end and separate it so it's not in my way that I accidentally don't grab it. Because nothing worse than putting it all back together and it's still doing the same thing.
Oh, yeah.
So, same deal. You just hold the board up, and you're just going to reverse it. You want to come in from an angle. Just come in from an angle. It only goes in one way. Can't miss it. And push it all the way tight. You'll see the plastic tabs have to be on top. The only way it's going to go.
Yeah.
See these here?
And the holes should line up, right?
The holes line up. Everything should line up perfectly. It shouldn't be. You don't want to force anything. You don't want to make it. You know what I mean? If it's not going on, there's a reason. Now, it's going to be tight. Tighter than the coming off. Most times.
Yeah.
Now the carriage, you're going to put the carriage back on you, so you're going to have to hold all this so you don't push it off. And then on the bottom of this carriage is actually a catch. And you want to make sure that catch ends up, I'll show you here, on the bottom of this board. If it ends up above it, the screws won't seat down.
Sure.
So all you're going to do is line up, just start lining it up here, and then just push it. I mean, you got to work with it a little bit.
This is probably going to take, if this is the first time you're doing this, I know when I first did this, it's going to take you a couple minutes probably to get this on. Don't get frustrated. Just take your time. If it doesn't line up, take it off, put it back on. Dan has done this probably a couple hundred times, so you know it's
and you don't want to force it.
Yeah.
Now, this is the biggest thing. You don't want to force it on there. And then this on the back side here, I'll show you if I can get it turned around here, is this carriage. When it locks on, it needs to be on the bottom. I don't know if you can see that. Let me see if I get an angle for them. Can you see
that? I know it's
that?
Confusing. The camera's
backwards. But see, the carriage will be, this part here will be actually under the board. And the easiest way to tell if you're not under it, when you go to reassemble it, this part, once you put everything back in, will be setting way high on the board. And then when you tighten it down, when you put a cartridge in, the carriage will not lock down.
Yeah.
Pretty straightforward on that. So once you get it all back in, you got a, the bottom shield sometimes can be a little bit of a pain because they have a shield.
Yeah, there's a bottom part to this metal piece.
Right, that locks it.
That they, it screws together, so yeah.
So when you put it in, it's pretty, goes in one way. There's actually little plastic notches. Let me see if I can find one for it. Sometimes when you have them out, they don't go back quite as easy. There's little plastic notches for it right here. You'll see, I don't know if you can see that there. Yeah, see that little plastic notch. And that'll show you that you're in right. Now, when you're putting this back together, it's very important that these cables here, right here on the front, they're controller port cables and your power cable and your reset cable, that they're not underneath that board when you go to screw it on. I've done this before. You'll screw it on and you'll actually screw through the wire. And then when you put it back together, it doesn't work at all. So you've actually made it worse. So it's one of them things when you go to reassemble it, just make sure them wires are clear. Look in them holes and make sure you don't see wires.
Yep.
And don't be afraid, the wires ain't going to break. You can just push them out of the way. It's what I usually do. Just make sure they're all pushed out of the way and everything like that.
Yep. You were supposed to say hello to Connor.
Hi, Connor.
He used to come in the store all the time.
Oh, Hamby. Right?
I don't know who it is. I don't know.
Hi, Connor. If it's the one I'm thinking of. So let me know.
Hey, what's up, Casey? How's it going, man? Welcome to the stream. All right. Go ahead. I'm sorry to interrupt.
No, that's okay. Yeah, it's my first stream, man. So I'm not 100% flowful.
Hey, guys, throw up the hashtag DanNutDave. Dan's doing an awesome job. Oh. Make sure you guys give him some love. He's doing awesome, guys.
That's all right. So then usually what I do, once I get the setup here, I'm going to put these screws in that hold the carriage and everything in. And basically, I'll test the system before I reassemble everything. That way I know it works. Because sometimes you have to take it apart and maybe readjust to make sure things are connecting properly. Nothing worse than putting every screw back in it and have to take it all apart.
Yeah.
So we're going to just put the longer screws, and remember, go in the middle. You know, we have everything seated in, so we're going to take the longer screws. If I can see them here. See,
and that was Hanby. That is correct.
Oh, well, very good.
You have a good memory. A lot of Dan not Dave is being thrown out there, Dan.
Oh,
a lot of support out there.
Thank you. So I usually put the longer screws in first.
What's up, Shane? How's it going, man?
And then we'll put the other screws to hold the whole carriage.
Yeah, it's a really good idea when you can. Check the system before you put it all together. There's nothing worse than putting it all together and it still not work. So what's nice is that on a lot of the retro consoles, that you can test the system before you put it back together. And
that's correct.
Highly recommend doing that. And once again, congratulations to Ryu. Ryu Car, if you guys don't know who that is, can the mod please put Ryu's command up there. Ryu won the NES. He is a streamer here on YouTube Gaming. I know a lot of people thought it was rigged because he won, and I was so close to drawing a new name because I knew people would think I was rigging it, but I thought it would be even worse if I did that. So congratulations to Ryu, very happy that you can do this, that this system's all yours. And
you want to hand me the power cord, David? Yeah, I think absolutely. It's down there, probably lost the end cord. We're going
to
test
right,
this out.
We're going to test it out, fingers crossed.
Give it the good blow. It's a little one.
There we go. Yep. Here we go. Look at that. Oh.
And we have here. Why don't you play it for a second, Dave? I usually like to play it for a second. All right.
Let me put this back up here. There we go. All right. Here we go, guys.
So he's going to test it a little bit more. I usually like to run a little bit and make sure it's going to hold. Sometimes they get a little funny on you halfway through. Once he gets through this, we'll reassemble it all back together and then retest it.
I got to beat the first level, right?
Yes, you do. That's like a speed run for you.
Yeah, right.
You could probably do that blindfolded.
Yeah, right. Oh! It's hard from...
Yeah, from the angle. Playing it backwards.
All right, let's try this one more time. It seems to be working good, though. But the physics are so different. Like, after playing Mario Maker for hundreds of hours... The physics are so different in this game, it's ridiculous.
You still got it, Dave. Dave's amazing at this Mario Maker. I watch him play it, and I'm
right. We got a lot of people that are a lot better at this.
And some
game.
Of these guys that are making these levels,
Wow. Some people have no, you know, they're so
very
mean.
Creative too.
They're creative, but they're mean to me. They want to see me fail. All right, it's good.
Okay, it's good. So what we're gonna do is just power it down and reassemble everything. Basically, just reverse it all. Just very important on these when you put them back together that you make sure them wires are out of the way. And you'll see, and there's only like, there isn't a whole lot to the system. So we're gonna, after we do all that, we'll put the two back in the corners. Usually how I go, I just reverse everything I did from the beginning.
And you know something's wrong if you have leftover screws at the end. You will use all the screws. Dan better play next time. The ultimate joke. Thank you for the GGs, guys. I know you guys aren't used to seeing me beat an actual level in Mario. Normally, I don't beat them, so.
And sometimes the metal shield's the same way. It can give you a pain going back together, but this, you'll see this little metal piece that sets up. The shield actually goes under that, and you'll see. And then the same deal with them little plastic tabs. They line up the exact same way.
Hey, what's up, Floyd? I didn't see you in here, man. What's up, Floyd? Dog 17, what's up, my man? How are you? Everyone's saying GG. I can't tell if you guys are being sarcastic. Just kidding. So, Dan, while you're putting this back together, why don't you tell them, what are some of your favorite NES games? You know, what's some of your memories of this?
Contra, I think I've put so many hours and raged so much as in my youth that over that game. That
so
game is
good.
Amazing.
So,
Chippendale, like the Rescue Rangers.
That's an awesome game that no one ever talks about.
You know, the Marios, the Zeldas, everybody loves, so that I don't mention that as often because it's kind of a standard.
Yep. I love Punch-Out. I think Punch-Out's a series that Nintendo needs to...
Yeah.
I mean, they had one on the Wii, but...
Yeah.
And it was good, but, you know, I love Punch-Out.
Yeah, and Super Punch-Out wasn't bad for the Super Nintendo, but it still never captured the classic feel.
I think the first one is still definitely the best. Hey, what's up? Lair, my man Lair and David Koba and David Connolly. How's it going, guys? Welcome. Ryu, I don't want to talk about that. Dan has in fact beaten it with Contra with 3 lives. I personally have not. I'm still working on that.
A long time ago, I probably couldn't get through the first level with 3 lives. Now
it's tough. It's really tough. Like I said, Ryu out there, Ryu speed runs it. He beat it in about 15 minutes,
wow.
Which is ridiculous.
I would love to see that. I'm sure it's up there.
It's up there. I'll show it to you sometime for sure.
All right, then we're gonna put the cover back on.
Now, Ryu, when you get this, the pin set's probably going to be a little bit tight, you know, because it's a newer pin set, and that's normal. It's supposed to be tight. Just be careful with it, you know.
It'll break in.
Yeah, you'll break it in, but if it feels tighter than normal, it's supposed to. Oh, he meant to ask what your PB was, your personal best for that game is.
All right,
so we're going to hook it back
up. Yeah, let's hope it holds, because I don't want to have to take it back apart.
Again, and with the original NES and stuff, you know, even though it's a new pin set, still doesn't guarantee that it's going to work first try every time. Although it is right now, which is awesome.
That's awesome.
So, Dan, now why don't you play? They want to see you play.
Yeah.
Even though you're at an absolutely awful angle.
I am. Let's see if I can... See if I can get through this.
But yes.
Let's see if we can get.
Yeah, this is an absolutely. Oh, nice jump.
Yeah. I used to play this just all the time on these. I used to speed run them, but I was never very good at them.
But it's. What was I going to say? Yeah, so don't be shocked if, Ryu, when you get it, if it doesn't work every single time right off the bat. You still might have to monkey with it. But for the most part, you're going to be good for another 30 years with this system, Ryu. Nice. Home stretch. Last two Goombas. Mm-hmm. Nice. Got it. He got it.
Yeah, I've played this forever.
Boom. Look at that. He did way better than I did.
I've played this level more times on repairs than I can care to mention. That was the biggest
thing. Yeah, he's fixed a lot of NES's. So, that was Any other tips on fixing an NES, Dan, or anything?
No, there isn't a whole lot to them. Now, there, I mean, there's other repairs that you get into, but probably 90% of the repairs is a pin set will solve most of your problems.
Yeah.
I mean, there's other things, you know, that you have to do for more complicated repairs, and I think at some point maybe we'll get into that, you know, depending on what you guys want to see.
Again, this was the first one, guys. We were this is kind of like a test run. We didn't know what to expect, you know, we didn't know anything like that. So if you guys are liking this, we will definitely keep doing this. Hey, what's up, Finch? How's it going, man? Ryu said, this system will outlive me. That's probably true. But yeah, so if you guys want, we're willing to do anything. It's not, I mean, not really me. It's Dan that's fixing them. I'm just kind of his wingman here. Yeah. But cartridge repair, someone asked.
Yeah, cartridge repairs too. I mean, some of the repairs, the biggest thing on a lot of them require soldering techniques.
Yeah.
And, you know, down the road, I think we could do that. I mean, it's not nothing.
Even if you just showed some general soldering tips, that might even be good as
well.
Yeah,
you know, whatever you want to see, just throw it out there, and we'll see if we can put it together for you.
Absolutely.
And maybe if this starts rolling pretty good, we can let you know far enough ahead that we're going to do it. And these are the tools and things you're going to need to do it. That way you can...
If you do that, let them know what tools you're going to need again, Dan, for this repair. That would probably be a good idea.
I mean, the two biggest things, really, is a screwdriver, a medium screwdriver... 3 inches or longer.
It's a Phillips.
Phillips head. And a 72-pin connector. Most of the parts I've always bought off eBay, you could buy them. Like, they'll sell them at 10 at a time, and you can end up with $4 or $5 a piece. If you're buying them individually, they're $6 to $10 with free shipping. Normally, first class, you get them in a couple days.
Yeah.
You know, so, and that's really it. I mean, a little bit of alcohol that you need for your cartridges, stuff like that, that if you're into retro gaming, a lot of that you probably are aware of. You know, Q-tips, alcohol, pencil erasers, and things like that. Well,
let me read the comments real quick. I think someone had a question or
something.
Thank you, Lair. I appreciate that, man. I appreciate that. Lair said, keep it up. It's a fantastic concept. Thank you, man. I think this is an awesome idea. Can't wait to see what gets fixed next.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, just throw us what you want.
Hey, what's up, Diamond Turtle? You are a little bit late, man. Just feel free to rewind it, dude. Final Fantasy has a battery, so another battery question. Yep. My Wii doesn't play GameCube games. Would that just be like a laser?
Well, as long as it has the ports on the top, you know, that it can. I mean, like all the newer style Wiis that came out actually have the GameCube spot on the software. But if you don't have the ports on the top, it won't play the GameCube games. If you have the ports on the top for the GameCube controllers... then you should be able to play GameCube games, and that could very well be the laser itself, or if the disc isn't being taken all the way in. A lot of times you should hear it drop when it goes in,
sure.
And if it isn't dropping, so it could very well be. But a Wii replacement's actually pretty easy. Wii drive replacement.
Someone asked, my Nintendo Wii doesn't turn on anymore. This is actually a good chance that this. George, this is a very, very, you might think we're crazy here. You know, don't leave the stream here and be like, wow, those guys are nuts. There's a very, very good chance that your power brick for your Wii just needs like reset kind of thing. So what you need to do, take your Wii your power pack, take it about waist high, maybe a little bit higher, go to a carpeted area. Just drop it on the floor, man. Just drop it onto the floor.
Disconnect it from the Wii.
Yes, disconnect it from the Wii and the wall. Just your power brick by itself. Drop it, man. Plug it back in. I would be shocked if it doesn't work then. Yeah. I would be shocked.
Yeah, that's awesome. Because that's a thing when we would tell people in the store, remember?
Absolutely. They would bring their systems in.
And what it is in the Wii power brick itself... is there's actually a fuse, a trippable fuse. Think of a breaker on your house, the same deal. If it gets a power surge or fluctuation in the power, it actually trips that breaker.
Yep.
And then when you drop it on the floor, it actually resets that. 9 out of 10 times, you plug it in the wall, plug it in after dropping it on the floor, it'll work. Sometimes you have to drop it a couple times. But in the event, if the red light isn't lighting up on your Wii, I mean, the power brick would need replaced. Yeah. But they're cheap enough
now. Yeah, those are cheap. Yeah. All right, so... I mean, I think that covers it about.
I'm looking forward
I hope you guys liked it. You know, I think it went really well. You know, like I said, this was the trial run here, so we were, you know, our setup was kind of thrown together here, I think it looks good. And yeah, any final questions or anything? Hey, what's up, Mike 500? How's it going, dude? Welcome to the stream. I think we're just about done, guys. Sorry that for those of you that just came in a little bit later here, but we are, you know, we're actually. about finishing up here.
I mean, it's the first time out of the gate. I've never been on a live stream before, and Dave's like the veteran, so, you know, he's been doing this for a while.
Yeah, I mean, it takes a little bit to get used to being in front of the camera. You know, if you make a mistake, everyone can see it.
And that's okay, though, because it's going to happen.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's the thing with repairs, like we were saying, that stuff happens with repairs. You know, it's never going to go, usually, 100% smoothly. Usually there's a hitch in something, so that's what's going to be cool about it. Do you know how to fix a scratched disc?
Oh, that's a resurfacing is basically what it is.
Yeah, which is able to be done. But Dan, go ahead.
No, that's okay.
Touch on that.
Yeah, resurfacing, the way discs are made, I mean, you can, they have a big chunk of plastic on the bottom that if they get scratched, the laser can't read through that. So basically you have to take it somewhere or send it in somewhere. And they do it over here at the store, Video Game Exchange. But they take it in, they actually resurface it. It's a wet polish that polishes the scratch off. And discs can be repaired.
They can be. Now, I've heard that some public libraries actually have resurfacers. I don't know if that's true or not. But basically, you're going to want to call around Dog17. Find out, you know, look for places that
do
say
resurfacing.
That, resurfacing, you know. There's videos online of people putting peanut butter and toothpaste and stuff.
And wax, and furniture polish.
We don't recommend that because that can damage your system and it can actually damage your
game. And that's, you bring
well,
up a valid
so.
Point there. I mean, they might work when they do that. And basically what they're doing is they're filling the scratch. But that stuff, that peanut butter oil and things like that, might get internally on your components or on your laser, and then you're back to a bigger problem than you started with, because then it won't read any of your discs.
Absolutely. Well, Dan, any final thoughts here?
That's great to be here with you, and Dave's been wonderful keeping me in check and keeping me on the flow of the program.
Yeah, we're really excited.
And I'm welcome all of you that were here, and I hope to hear from you in the future on maybe possible future repairs.
Yeah,
and
absolutely. If you guys have any ideas, once this video is all completed and whatnot, you can leave comments in the comment section of this video. You know, repairs that you want to see and everything like that, and we'll be happy to do them. So this one was kind of short, it's only half hour, but some repairs take hour and a half, depending on what it is. So this one was a little short. We wanted to do one that wasn't too in depth, and it's a pretty common problem that a lot of people have
with the retro gamers. But that has been great. It's great to see everybody and thank everybody for coming out.
Yeah, let's do a raid. I don't know if I'm gonna be streaming tonight. There was supposed to be a Mario Maker blind race tonight with the possibility of winning money, or not money, but Nintendo gift cards. However, Nintendo Mario Maker is going to be under maintenance from 8 p.m. for 5 hours, so the race has been pushed to next week. So, but let's see if anyone is streaming here.
I've never been on a raid before.
You've
either
never been on a raid. I don't know if anyone is streaming right now. Let's check YouTube Gaming out. Dan, what's one of the rarest, I'm looking for this, what's one of the rarest Nintendo games that you have? Because I know Nintendo is full of hidden gems. There are so many games on the system, and there's, a lot of rare titles out there. So
I would say probably one of the rarest games in my collection is Bonk's Adventure.
Okay.
It's a great game. I wish I had it complete. I don't. I just have the cartridge only, but the label's nice.
Absolutely.
So that's probably one of the rarest. I ended up getting right before the store got bought out, Wayne's World Complete in the box. Terrible game. Sometimes it makes you wonder why some of these games are not very fun at all to play.
Absolutely.
But yeah, the Nintendo, there's a lot of them. It seems like even the sports titles for Nintendo games have actually climbed quite a bit.
It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous for sure. Thank you, Floyd. I appreciate that, guys. And thank you, everyone. What's up, Copitz? What's your question, man? Can you help me with my DS Lite? Doesn't charge. Possibly in the future, Lugia, that will definitely be one that maybe we can do. The thing with handhelds, they're a little bit, they're so small, so it's really, really intricate. And, the camera might not catch everything that we need to. But, we can talk about it.
Oh, absolutely. The easiest thing to check if it won't charge and it still turns on or anything is a battery replacement. That's the easiest thing to check.
Yeah.
$6 or $7 for a battery. I would recommend just changing the battery. Other than that, there's fuses and things in there. And they're a little more complicated to get into because the parts are so small, like Dave was saying.
Yeah.
That that it definitely takes a steady hand to work on them. Even me, over the years, I can only do two or three
max. Yeah, your hand will cramp up.
My hand cramps up, my eyes hurt, and get half a headache.
Yeah, absolutely. But, hey, what's up, Kyle? I didn't see you in here, man. Welcome, Kyle Garthwaite. How are you? And Kopitz asks, is there a way to fix an N64 analog stick without a replacement stick?
Not normally, no. Usually you have to replace it. Over the years, I have tried to find ways because I've replaced so many sticks that there's a spring in there to put tension on them, and you can't find that spring anywhere. And I've looked.
Yeah.
I've spent over the
years. And the replacement sticks aren't expensive.
No.
You know, so it's, you're going to, if you're trying to fix it, you might spend 4 or 5 hours trying to fix a little part where you can spend $5
right.
and buy a stick.
And a thing to try, too, is try one of the, they do make a GameCube analog stick as a replacement that actually feels a little bit better than the original replacement sticks.
It does.
So, and you can pick them up for like $1 or $2 more. And they're pretty easy to change.
It's very easy. We actually have a video on our YouTube channel on how to replace those.
Oh, nice. So. I didn't realize that.
I think we do. I don't know. It's been a while, so. All right, guys, I actually looked. There's no one streaming right now that I'm subscribed to Raid, so we're probably just going to cut the stream. But if I stream tonight, I'll probably be doing some Mario World speedrun attempts. Maybe. I don't know. We'll see. But stay tuned for that. But thank you guys so much for being here.
Thank you for coming.
Really, really appreciate it. And have a great day, guys. We'll see you
later. We'll see you next round.